Hi everybody, it's Martin at Flicking Feathers again today, and I'm tying a billfish fly today. This is a flashy profile tube. It looks like this when it's finished. But in the vise I've already started a 2.5 inch, 67 mil, large diameter plastic tube. And I've just run on some heavy, this is 280 denier UTC in fluorescent orange. And I've put a bit of super glue on that just to sort of give it a nice durable solid base. So there are few, but a lot of each material in this, right? You don't need many, but you do need a lot of them. So this is, I've got a bunch of pearl saltwater flashaboo here. We've got a big bunch. I might actually need to add a bit more though, it's a wee bit light. So take a gathering wrap, offer it up. This is only got to be in the belly side. Get a couple of loose turns. Then you can just use your thumb to sort of spread it. And you want it, you can see there it's like half. So it's spread around half of the diameter of the tube. I might add a few more strands to that. You don't need to be shy with this. It's a big flashy fly. I probably get 2 packets of pearl will do 3 flies. And 2 silver for the, we'll do 4 more or less. It depends on depends on which brand you buy, because the packets on there are the same size. I just get mine off of eBay, but they're reasonable packs. That's better. So it's just a wee bit fiddly at first, so get that tied in nice and tight, plenty of wraps, and then you can fold it back. Now this will go better if you fold just a few at a time. You can crush the bump with your thumbnail. Just don't catch any strands. Plenty of tight wraps to hold it nice and secure. Take a wrap down onto the tube and back up, it'll help to lock it in place. That's the belly. I'll just loosen my tube adapter a bit and let that twist so I can get the back on. Tighten that back up. And then basically it's the same process, but this time with silver flashaboo. Same the Magnum saltwater stuff. Set that aside. And you want this, you make sure your tie-in point's the same, don't be creeping forward. Right, so I'm tying that directly on top of the tie-in of this, the pearl. Fold it back. The pearl stuff, the second bunch is easier to fold because you've already got that sort of slightly wider base because you've tied the pearl in. Now again at this stage I like to come in with some super glue. There's no harm. It just stops it from slipping. Tighten that a wee bit more. Right, now we're getting, you can go and get some nice tight wraps. Next is to tie in the belly. And I'm just using, this is just super hair. Or ultra hair, streamer hair. It's all much of a muchness. Just depends on the brand. Really, it doesn't make any practical difference when you're fishing flies like this. So, and again, another quite generous pack, bunch. Just turn this over, and this can be about three quarters of the length of the flash. Just get a wee sort of pre-taper, you want the flash that hanging out behind it. Tie that in, fold it back on the other. Another side, so spread that across. And we can, you can just move it to suit. Nice, get it lashed down, nice and secure. It looks a bit crazy at this stage because of the tube adapter and what have you, but it does come together. And then for the middle of the back, I've got to use some green, same material, it's kind of green colour. Similar size bunch. Again, I'll just pre-taper it. And same kind of length, about 3/4 of the length of the flash. Again, keep your tie in at the same place, don't go forward. Hold it back, tie over it. Get everything locked in place. You start to see it taking shape. That's sort of minnow shape. Next we'll go for some blue. Same size bunch. And you want this to be just slightly shorter than the green. Right? It helps form this that slight taper. And you can allow your tying to come a wee bit forward. If you notice, I've actually just used the same full length of the super hair. It just keeps your hank neater if you just cut a full length. So because this is slightly shorter at the back, I don't know if you can see it, I'm allowing my tie in for it, my fold tush to be slightly further forward, which will bring this back end, make it slightly shorter and help keep the taper in the fly. And then it's just a case of folding it back over again. Keep it on top. That sort of gives you that nice bait fish profile. Don't worry about this, I know it doesn't look very good, but this won't, but it'll all be tidied up. Again, just some super glue. Just stop sending slipping. These materials are nice and really slick, so the super glue helps prevent your thread from slipping. Build that up a bit. And then, just to finish off the top, I'm going to take some blue flashaboo. Slightly smaller clumps than before. This is just to sort of top off the back. A wee bit uneven. Tie it in, just control it with your thumbnail. Same, fold it again. Then it's time for the sides. And the sides are just more the pearl. Still quite a big bunch, no maybe as much as earlier, but decent sized bunches. Oh shit. And this should be shorter. This should be about half the length of the overall fly. Both sides in before I fold these. Just make sure everything's sitting nice. You can see how everything's like sort of been hidden, any of the mess earlier, the sort of untidy bumps and all that, and where you tied the super here, that's all been hidden. Then it's just a case now covering everything up. Oops. Need to get a bit more glue. The thread slipping on the material, so you may find you need to just get some super glue on it. Which does no harm, it adds a bit of extra durability. Still got a bump in the far side there. So I'll just come in again. Bit more super glue. Once that's all finished up, I'm just coming again with a bit more glue, this time on my thread, just run it round. Show me your thread and then just quickly touch it into the super glue. Gives you a solid head. It's going to be coated anyway. You'll finish the fly with some epoxy or resin. Got a couple of big eyes. These are 15mm eyes. Superglue them in place. Stuck it to my table. To the other side. Just check them. Sure the position's right, give them a squeeze. And that same glued in, then I won't film it, but what you would then do is finish the fly with some epoxy just to secure the eyes completely and add a bit of a toughness. But that's basically it. That's the flashy profile tube. Just get a brush. Can brush it. Obviously, if you like, you can come in with some markers, colour it up, like a bit of red at the throat. Markers, over it. Better. I like to do this before I do any put any resin or anything on because it gets the colour right in to the base of the thread. Get a wee throat tied up, you can stripe it, you can do what you like. But that's basically it. The reason I tied this, well, I'm tying some for myself anyway, but the reason I did the video is that I just noticed there weren't any. So, any videos of billfish flies. So, there you go. I hope that was useful. I hope if you're planning to go somewhere for sailfish or maybe some marlin, and you fancy tying your own flies, you can tie up some of these and take them with you. Catch a couple of fish in them, if you're lucky. So, thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to give me a thumbs up below. And remember to subscribe to my channel, share the video, etc. Tight lines. Bye.